Shouldn't you be reading Ronin romance classics? A case in point.
Discovered. The heathen band of godless men pirates began to close in, intent on having their lecherous way with me. Their filthy eyes devoured my scanty dress, their rancid breath burping up their unbridled lust. Alone and helpless. What could be worse? Alone and helpless. In my old prom dress, that's what could be worse. Alone and helpless. Alone. Helpless. Alone. Helpless. Alone. Helpless. Suddenly, there he was, their leader, a vain, vile, repulsive man. At long last, love, we would never be parted. Our union would pass the blood test of time, the entrance exam of eternity. The ID check at the doors of heaven. But no. I stopped to refresh myself with a chaste and proper bath. Trapped by a heathen gang of godless men bandits intent on having their lecherous way with me. Alone and helpless. Suddenly, there he was, their leader. A vain, vile, really repulsive man. Oh, suddenly there he was. Their leader. We have a winner. At long last,
join Bev Flemmer, average housewife, as she travels back in time to experience romance, adventure, lust, intrigue, lust, danger, and the ever-popular lust. And all she has to do to get back home safely is to click her knees together three times. Oops. Which goes a long way toward explaining why she's 2 years late for the family breakfast. Yes, let Ronin Romance Classics take you to the world you deserve.
So!
Maybe not.
You think you're going out with the boys again tonight? When will you ever grow up?
Dear sir, I am writing in response to your written request for additional information about my recent accident. In block number 3 of the accident reporting form, I put poor planning as a cause of the accident. You stated in your letter that I should explain more fully. I trust the following details will be sufficient. I am an amateur radio operator. On the day of the accident, I was working alone on the top section of my new 80-foot tower antenna. When I had completed my work, I discovered that I had, over the course of several trips up the tower, brought up about 300 pounds of tools and hardware. Rather than carry the now unneeded tools and hardware down the tower in several trips by hand, I decided to lower the items into a small barrel by using a pulley, which, fortunately, was attached to the gen pole on the top of the tower. Securing the rope at the ground level, I went up to the top of the tower and loaded the tools and hardware into the barrel. I then proceeded back to the ground and untied the rope, holding tightly to ensure a slow descent of the 300 pounds of tools and hardware. You will please note block number 11 of the accident reporting form, where I entered my weight as being 155 pounds. Due to my absolute surprise at being so abruptly jerked off the ground, I lost my presence of mind and forgot to let go of the rope. Needless to say, I proceeded at a rapid rate up the side of the tower. In the vicinity of the 40-foot level, I met the barrel, which was coming down. I trust this will explain my fractured skull and broken collarbone. Slowed only but slightly, I continued my rapid ascent, not stopping until the fingers of my right hand were knuckles deep into the pulley. At approximately the same time, however, the barrel impacted the ground and the bottom fell out of the barrel. I refer you, again, to my weight in block number 11. Devoid of the weight of tools and hardware, the barrel now weighed 20 pounds. As you might imagine, I began an extremely rapid descent down the side of the tower. In the vicinity of the 40-foot level, I again met the barrel, which was now coming up. This will account for the two fractured ankles and multiple lacerations on my lower body. The second encounter with the barrel slowed my descent enough to lessen my injuries when I next fell on the pile of tools and hardware. Fortunately, only 3 vertebrae were cracked. However, I am sorry to report that while in pain, unable to move, and watching the empty barrel 80 feet above me, I again lost my presence of mind and let go of the rope.
Thank you. know how much I love you. Never know how much I care. When you put your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever. When you hold me tight, fever. In the morning, a fever all through the night. Sun lights up the daytime, moon lights up the night. I light up when you call my name, and you know I'm gonna treat you right. You give me fever. Romeo loved Juliet. Juliet, she felt the same. When he put his arms around her, he said, Julie, baby, you're my flame. Now give us fever. When we kiss her, fever with thy flame in you. Fever, I'm a fire. Fever, yea, I burn. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.